There we go. All right. So hopefully you guys have something comfortable to be laying down on. We're going to be starting on our backs here in supine or face up position. So I'll let you guys come on down to the ground. We're going to be going into our wall slides. So arms straight up overhead, slowly bringing those elbows down, going through that full shoulder range of motion here for 10. If there's something kind of gross underneath you, you don't have to slide the arms. You can kind of just hover them above the ground if you're either outside. I know Abdu's on his patio.
Yes.
Loosen up your shoulders. So when you guys are done with that, I'll have you stay down on the ground here for our next one. I'm just going to go through
everybody
and
everybody can go through and mute themselves quick.
Yeah.
That'd be awesome.
Everyone quickly here. There we go. So once you get your 10 for those wall slides, we're going to be on all fours into our T-spine. What that means is we're just taking our elbow, bringing it across to your other arm, and then opening up that chest all the way to the sky or to the ceiling. Nice and slow. We'll do 5 on one side, and then you guys can switch and do 5 on the other side. So really focusing on that thoracic or just upper back rotation. I'm a little limited by my shoulder and my chest right now. And then our last one down here before we get up to our feet, or if you have any type of chair or bench around you, into your scapular push-up. So you don't have to go up on your tiptoes. You can stay on either knees or all fours. And we're just squeezing behind the shoulder blades and relaxing. And let's go through and do 12 on this one. So nice big squeeze behind. And then a slow relax or release. Going through thinking about your posture, especially if you're someone working from home or if you have a station set up where you're still sitting in an office type of setup. Thinking about keeping those shoulders back in your upright posture, even if you're working on the computer or making conference calls all day. And then when you guys are done with that, I'll have you show me you guys are done by getting up to your feet here. There you go. So I think some people are finishing up. Our next one is going to be standing. If you want to use any countertop or wall for balance to hold on to, we're just going to be doing a low to high leg swing. So start nice and low. If you want to do a medium in between and then nice and high, we'll go through 5 low to highs on one side and then go ahead and switch 5 low to highs on the other. So don't necessarily want you to go into that max swing right away, especially since this is our first leg warm up that we're doing here, trying to ease into it a little bit today, especially for me as I just woke up less than an hour ago. Yeah. So yeah, a few people finishing up. Your next one is going to be the same thing. We're starting at a slow pace, doing 10 butt kicks. And then after you get done with that 10, then we're going to go into fast for a 10 butt kicks. So start out nice and slow. Again, thinking about that range of motion, getting those joints loosened up, and then going to those fast kicks after.
Matt, can you mute yourself?
What?
I'm going to put you on mute, okay?
Yeah.
Sorry about that. So we got two left here. The next one I'll have you do just with body weight. Otherwise, we're going to be doing it with your laundry detergent or any type of weight today. Is going to be down in the middle and then up to the side for your wood chops. And then pivot away as you move up to that opposite shoulder. So all the way through, still think about that rotation through the hips up to the back, getting everything nice and loose. Obviously, if you have a low ceiling, kind of watch that you're not gonna hit the object onto like a light or a ceiling or a low overhead beam there. And again, we'll just be doing about 10 on each side or guesstimating about 10. I'll kind of watch y'all and see when everyone's kind of finishing up. There we go. I think someone's got a backpack or small suitcase there. I like seeing that. And then your last one is going to be our cardio or aerobic kind of heart rate starter, is your W hops. So moving those feet all the way across and back in your W or lightning bolt. And we'll go for five total. So five down and backs. Nice and light on those toes. Gentle hops, especially if you have anyone underneath you. Nice soft landing. I'm still waiting to receive any type of noise complaint myself, as I'm always jumping around up here on the fourth floor. Okay. So if you're someone new to our Saturday session, it's going to be similar to what we did last week, a 3x3x3, meaning we have three circuits of three exercises each, and we're going to be doing each circuit three times. And then our work to rest ratio is going to be 30 seconds on and 15 seconds off. And I'll just go through this first circuit, and then when we take a break after the first three rounds, then I'll take you through the middle and then the last one and so forth. So your first one, you're going to be needing that lightweight, whether you're, I'll be using a backpack or if you have like a milk or water jug or laundry detergent. You guys are going to be going through and doing your single arm swings here. So what we used to do with our kettlebell, where you want to start nice and low and go into your hip extension. So you're using your hips to propel your weight. So I can even show you guys with our jug, hands nice and high, and then exploding through the shoulder should be doing minimal amount of work. We have 30 seconds on. I would recommend starting with your weaker side first. So 30 seconds on that weaker side. And then your second exercise is gonna be 30 seconds on with the other arm. So kind of pick any type of object that's gonna be most challenging for you, but you feel like you don't have to crank through with that shoulder. And then that third exercise is just gonna be a squat hold here. So we'll be holding all of us together for 30 seconds. Otherwise, if you want, you can also do a wall sit, prop yourself up with the back against the wall and bring those hips down as low as you can into your hold for that 30 seconds. Does anyone have any questions on other things that they could potentially use for those swings at all? Does everyone have something that they feel comfortable going through and using that they're not gonna let go of or break anything here? All right, I saw some thumbs up. I'm gonna get the timer started. We got 10 seconds here. go ahead, play your own music. I don't know if you'll be able to hear mine too well in the background.
3, 2, 1, go.
There we go. So starting nice and low. Use that momentum from the hips to bring that weight higher. And then once you get to about shoulder height here, that's where I want you to do your best. Stay consistent. Going through, backs are nice and flat. Power through with those hips. Explode forward.
3, 2, 1, rest.
There we go. So hopefully as you get ready for that stronger side, it'll be a little bit more manageable.
3, 2, 1, go.
There we go. Keep that core nice and tight. Protect that low back through your swing. Here we go. Last few seconds.
1, rest.
So go ahead, set that weight bag or container aside and get those legs ready for this squat hold here.
3, 2, 1, go.
Here we go, drop them down. Do your best, keep those hands either together as long as they're off the knees. Here we go, we're at well over halfway here. We got last 10 seconds. Here we go, nice, slow, calm breathing. Prepare yourself for the second round of swings here.
Rest.
Here we go, back to that weaker side.
3, 2, 1, go.
Here we go. Nice big breaths out as that weight comes forward. We got last 10 seconds here.
3, 2, 1, rest.
There it is, guys. We're starting off with this more aerobic circuit.
1, go.
And then our second one will be a little bit more core intensive. There it is. Nice form on those swings, guys. Everyone's looking good here. It is. Keep it up for this last 10.
3, 2, 1, rest.
Here we go. So getting ready for that wall sitter squat hold.
3, 2, 1, go.
Here we go. Nice and low as you comfortably can. There it is. Passing halfway here. There you go. Jen's got her detergent bottle she's holding on to. Julie's got some weights. I love it.
3, 2, 1, rest.
There it is. So if you want to for that last set of squat hold or wall sit, you can hold on to your weighted container.
3, 2, 1, go.
There it is. Last time through, guys. Making sure you're still protecting that low back with the core. Brace and block in that punch. There it is. Last 10 seconds. Keep powering through. Here we go. Last side for swings, coming in hot. There it is. Finish up this last little bit strong here, guys.
3, 2, 1, rest.
Here we go. Go ahead and rest. If you want that extra little weight or challenge for your hold, I'll grab a lighter container here for myself.
3, 2, 1, go.
Here you go. Making sure that chest stays up this time through. Weight still on the heels if you're not using a wall behind you. There we go. Working on slowing down that breathing rate from the swings here. You got 10 more seconds.
There
we go. Almost there.
2, 1, done.
Woo. Here we go. Circuit one and done. So go ahead, get a good quick drink of water if you need one. As well, if you would like any type of mat or cushion underneath you guys. Hopefully if you're outside, you either have grass or something that's a little bit more comfortable. I'll angle it down here and show you what we have for our next three. We're gonna be doing a weighted dead bug. So one arm's gonna be straight up in the air and then taking away that space between the low back, and we're extending opposite arm and leg. So right leg, left arm, or vice versa. And then extending, if you feel like, okay, there's a little bit of space between my low back, then I'll have you guys angle your limbs a little bit. So instead of kicking that leg straight out, it might be straight but angled nice and high. And I want to make sure you feel comfortable keeping contact the entire time, because we're doing that same one side for 30 seconds. And then we're going to switch for the second exercise and do the other side. And then as we did in our warm-ups, we have your W hops, or that lightning symbol down and back for the 30 seconds. So if you're someone that doesn't do hopping, you can either do kind of like a side to side without the jump, as long as you're keeping your feet moving for that entire 30 seconds. Anyone have questions on those? I know mainly two exercises, we're turning them into three. Thumbs up, everyone can still hear, timer good and everything. Yes, 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 cool. All right, so I'll get the second round going here and you guys can get set up on the ground with whatever weight or object you would like to use for those dead bugs.
3, 2, 1, go.
Here we go. So that one arm staying up the entire time here. Making sure that back is being pressed down into the ground, that core is engaged the whole time. Go. I'll move down a little bit here.
3, 2, 1, go.
There it is. Making sure that hand stays above the chest and shoulder the whole time. Don't let it get sucked backwards over your head. There we go. Up on the feet here for your hops. There it is. Quick feet, nice and soft. Ooh, if I could talk and jump at the same time, it'd be a miracle. There we go. We're well over halfway here, guys. There it is. Nice pace. Keep it up.
3, 2, 1, rest.
There it is. So I'm going to switch out my gallon of water here for a weight.
3, 2, 1, go.
Making sure we're keeping contact the whole time. Otherwise, change the direction that you're extending or kicking out.
3, 2, 1, rest.
There we go. Nice little breather in between sides here. It is passing halfway, guys, keeping that core engaged.
Three, two, one, rest.
Nice, getting ready for these hops. Such speed, very lightning.
3, 2, 1, go.
There we go, keep those feet together. Don't let them get sucked apart. Last half here, coming down to 10. Keep those feet up, keep them up, keep them up.
3, 2, 1, rest.
It is last time through, guys. So as we get down to our last seconds here, I want you guys to extend out and then hold. So on this one, I'll have you hold, 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 making sure that back stays down. Arms and legs are extended. And then you can relax. We'll do the same thing on the other side. Last few seconds, extending out, keeping that hold and contraction.
3, 2, 1, go.
There it is, nice and easy through. That full range of motion you can get, maintaining solid form here. So last one, and then get ready for that hold. So extend out, hold, hold, hold.
3, 2, 1, rest.
And then release. It is, nice work, guys. Last one on the feet for those hops.
3, 2, 1, go.
There you go. This is our only jumping one for the day. So give it all you got in this last 15 seconds here. There it is. Keep those feet up.
3, 2, 1, done.
Ooh. There it is. Go ahead and rest. Water if you need it. Whew. So for your last set is when we're going to need, if you have those looped bands, otherwise you can keep with the detergent jug or even backpack if you'd like. I'll show you guys two different options. I know some people are eventually going to be buying long bands. If you don't have them, that's still okay because we have a full 30 seconds for our first pairing here, which is going to be the same that we had last week. Into your 2-point or 3-point stance for your row. So I'll see if I can step back here and show you how I would personally set up a long one. And then I'm gonna be using the shorter one for today, but you guys can be down onto that front knee, back stays nice and flat, still good posture. I don't want those shoulders to be hunched forward. And then you're going to be pulling that bottom part of the resistance band. So the one that you have between the feet, elbows going back to the hip, maintaining flat back. Otherwise, if you have a smaller looped band here, I simply place it on my front foot, make sure again that it's not gonna snap up at you, and then pulling that elbow back. Otherwise, you guys can stay with your jug onto the knee, or if you wanna prop your arm up on to a chair, low bench, etc. Does anyone not have any type of weight or object that they're able to use for the rows? So it's still gonna be that first 30 seconds on, I would recommend that weak side first, and then 30 seconds on that right side. I'll scroll through here and just kind of wave your arms if you have any issues with getting that first one set up. Right, so everyone looks good as far as I can see. And then your third one, or second exercise, you're gonna be taking your weight and we're gonna be going into those wood chops that we did in our warm-up. So pivoting away down by the knees in between each one. Shoulders come through, it's like you're chucking the weight or object over the shoulder, but you're still staying in control with your core. You're not simply just whipping it like crazy. Everything still is engaged, enacted, and in control. It's not just like a willy-nilly. So we're just going over one shoulder and then down over to the other shoulder for that full 30 seconds. All right, so thumbs up. I'll go one more time through. I'm getting timer. If y'all are good, 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 good. Okay, I'll get the show on the road here then. Here we go. 10 seconds for that first side of rows.
3, 2, 1, go.
There we go, back's nice and flat. Shoulders are forward, whether you're in that 2-point or 3-point stance here, and then pulling back towards that hip. There we go, pacing yourselves. We still got 10 seconds here on this first side.
3, 2, 1, rest.
There you go. So relax, switch up, get ready for that other side. I know some of you are gonna have to switch the band down by your feet. You have a few seconds left to do so.
3, 2, 1, go.
There it is, nice work, guys. Everyone's posture looks solid. Backs are looking good on this first set here. Last 10 seconds.
Three, two, one, rest.
There it is. So by the time you get down to under 10, you should be pretty fatigued. So weights for these wood chops, side to side.
One, go.
Again, making sure as you come up, you're not gonna hit anything above you.
Three,
Here it is. Under 10. Last few. Try to get one more on each side.
One. Rest.
All right, back to that weak side for your rows.
Two, one, go.
I'm gonna go with my big band on this set. It is. Finish this side out strong.
Three,
last few.
Two, one. Rest.
And then we're going to get started.
Three,
this other side here.
One. Go.
Go. Keeping good solid contact with those feet if you're using a band. Make sure that guy doesn't slingshot up at you. Try last two here.
Three, two, one, rest.
Then we got back to the wood chops or those side to side.
Three, two, one, go.
Even if all you have is body weight, still going through that full range of motion in a controlled manner. So exploding through the hips and then reeling back with the arms at top. Under 10 seconds here. Here we go. Keep it up, guys.
Three, two, one, rest.
Whew. One more set to go. One more round.
Three, two, one, go.
So hopefully by now you found a good rhythm for these rows. If you tried to go really crazy and really fast for that full 30 seconds, it'd be pretty taxing. Keeping that nice solid form, especially in that back. I know we're getting tired. Do your best not to let that low back round out.
Three, two, one, rest.
And then hopefully your strong side here to finish off this pairing.
Three, two, one, go.
Here we go, nice big squeezes still as you get to the top. All the way through that full range of motion. And his last few here, guys.
Three, two, one, rest.
Finishing off strong with your wood chops.
Three, two, one, go.
Here we go. As you feel comfortable with the sequencing or pattern, we'll try to pick up the pace a little bit here. Still stay in control. Here it is. Finish it out.
Three, two, one, done.
There you go, you guys can rest.